Okay, so good morning class. So for today, in this video, we will discuss or we will just have a review on how we do bank reconciliation. Okay, so in bank reconciliation, one of the thing that we or the main focus of our reconciliation is what we call cash. So what is cash? So cash is considered as a medium of exchange used when selling or purchasing goods. So when we sell or purchase goods, usually it will involve the transfer of cash. So it's the one we are using when we are selling or purchasing goods. Also, in this bank reconciliation, we are considering check as a way of payment, which is sometimes check is also considered as cash, good as cash. So it is issued in payment of assets or merchandise purchased while collections are deposited. So if you are the one who is paying in check, then this is usually used to pay your assets or merchandise that you have purchased. While if you are the one who receives check, these are your collections from the customer and it will be deposited in the bank. Also, another thing that we should take note of consideration is the bank statement, which is a monthly report being released by the bank to the account holder of the checking account. So in a bank statement, you will be able to see there that it will start with the balance of the previous month, with transactions listed in chronological order showing the running balance after each transaction to finally arrive at the ending balance of the month. So in a bank statement, you will be able to see there the beginning balance of your cash in bank. Then later on, at the end of the bank statement, you will be able to see there the ending balance of your cash in banks after your deposited and deposits and withdrawals have been considered. So what are the transactions being listed in the bank statement? These are deposits, withdrawals, the checks that have been issued and paid, the interest that you earned, service charges, and all other transactions that transpired during the month affecting the account. So this is an example of a bank statement. As you can see there, we have the date, the description, the debit, credit, and balance. So class, please take note, in the bank statement, when we say credit, this will refer to all the increases in your bank balance. While debit, this will refer to the charges or deductions to your bank balance. Kung makikita nyo, di ba, kabaligtaran siya kapag sa journal natin sa cash. Kapag sa journal natin sa cash, ang credit ay ito yung mga nababawas sa cash mo. Pag debit, ito yung mga nadadagdag sa cash mo. Pero dito, kapag bank statement na pinag-uusapan natin, credit, ito yung mga increases, mga dagdag, while debit, these are decreases in your bank balance. So, a bank reconciliation is a schedule prepared to bring the depositor's cash balance and the related bank's cash balance into agreement. So, it shows the items causing the discrepancies between the balance per bank and the balance per book. Diba, meron tayo naka-record na cash in bank sa ating ledger. Itong cash in bank natin sa ledger, i-compare natin niya sa bank statement, sa balance ng cash natin sa bank statement. Kasi usually, hindi sila equal. So, ang ginagawa natin sa bank reconciliation, yung cash in bank natin sa ledger, sa records natin, sa records ng company, we reconcile them to the bank statement, the balance of cash in our bank statements, so that at the end of our bank reconciliation, they will be equal. So there are three methods of bank reconciliation. We have the unadjusted bank to book, unadjusted book to bank, and adjusted balance method. But for this discussion, we will just focus on the adjusted balance method. But let's define what are those methods. So the unadjusted bank to book balance method, in this method, we simply adjust the unadjusted balance per bank. So magsisimula tayo sa unadjusted balance per bank papunta sa unadjusted balance per book. So we are using the unadjusted balance per bank in order for us to get or to compute for the unadjusted balance per book. While on the unadjusted book to bank balance method, we are using the unadjusted book balance in order for us to derive at the unadjusted balance per bank. So, gagamitin mo yung unadjusted book balance and the reconciling items in order for you to get the unadjusted balance per bank. But in the adjusted balance method, we are adjusting both balance, the balance per bank and the balance per book, to the corrected cash balance that will be presented in the balance sheet. So, i-adjust mo yung balance per bank, then balance per book, so that at the end of their adjustments, you will have the corrected cash balance, which will be presented in your SFP, your Statement of Financial Position. So, in doing the bank reconciliation, we will notice that there are some bank reconciling items and also book reconciling items. Ano ba yon? Ano bang ibig sabihin nun? When we say bank reconciling items, these are the transactions related to cash that was recorded in the books already but not yet reflected in the bank statement. Kasi diba, ulit natin, kapag bank reconciliation, kino-compare natin si ledger natin sa bank statement na nare-receive natin. So, pag sinabi natin bank reconciling items, ito yung mga transactions na naka-record na sa books natin, sa ledger natin, pero hindi pa naka-record sa banko, sa bank statement natin. So, these are some of the bank reconciling items. First, we have deposit in transit. Second, we have outstanding checks. And third, we have the bank errors. So, isa-isahin natin sila. So, when we say deposit in transit, these are deposits already recorded in the company's books. Thereby, it will increase the cash balance but not yet recorded in the bank records. So, ito yung mga collection natin from customers na hindi pa natin na-deposit kay banko. So, sa atin, naka-record na siya. Pero kay banko, hindi pa siya naka-record dahil hindi pa natin nag-deposit. Example natin, kunwari, I received from my customer a payment amounting to 100,000. So, na-receive ko na siya. Dahil na-receive ko na siya, i-re-record ko na siya sa journal ko. Then, it will be reflected also to the ledger. Pero, na-receive ko yung pera ng around 6 p.m. ng gabi. Siyempre, yung time na yon sarado na ang mga banko. Hindi ko na siya madedeposit. Kinabukasan ko na siya madedeposit. So, ang mangyayari nun, nakarecord na sa akin, pero kay banko, hindi pa. Tumaas na yung cash sa records ko, pero kay banko, hindi pa siya reflected dahil hindi pa siya nadedeposit. Kaya ang ginagawa natin dito, if ever that we will have deposit in transit, it should be added to the cash in bank balance. Kasi nga, na-record na natin siya sa books natin, pero hindi pa kay bank. So kung nadagdag na natin siya kay book, dapat idagdag din natin siya kay bank para mag-i-equal sila. So if ever that in the problem, hindi given yung deposit in transit na amount, we can compute for that. So, we can compute for the deposit in transit by using this formula. Deposit in transit at the beginning of the month. So, magkano yung deposit in transit mo nung simula ng buwan? Add deposits made per book. So, i-add mo yung mga deposits na na-record mo na sa books less the deposits shown in the bank statement. So, magkano ba yung amount ng deposits na naka-record na sa bank statement? So, after using that, after following this formula, we will be able to get the deposit in transit at the end of the month. So now, how can you compute for the outstanding checks? So outstanding checks will refer to the checks being issued by the company but not yet paid by the bank. So, na-issue na ni company itong mga cheque na to, pero yung pinag-issuehan mo ng cheque, yung payee, hindi pa nagpupunta ng banko para i-encash yung cheque or i-deposit yung cheque sa account niya. So, these are outstanding checks. So, eto, sa point of view ni company, since na-issue mo na siya kay company, sa supplier mo, or kung kanino man siya i-issue, we record it as a deduction to cash already. Once you issued it to the customer at to the suppliers, then it should be deducted in your books. However, hanggat hindi pa pumupunta tong mga suppliers yung pinag-issuehan mo ng cheque sa banko, it will not be deducted in your bank balance. Hindi pa siya nababawas sa bank balance mo dahil hindi pa naman pumupunta yung supplier sa banko para i-encash yung cheque. So, ang nangyari dito, na-deduct na ni company sa records niya itong mga checking na issue, pero kay banko, hindi pa. Kaya ang gagawin natin, ibabawas na natin itong mga outstanding checks natin sa balance sa bank. So, if ever that the outstanding checks will not be given in the problem, this is how we can solve for the outstanding checks. So, outstanding checks at the beginning of the month plus the checks being issued at our records in the books less checks paid by the bank, yung mga na bayaran na ni banko, yung mga checking na encash na sa banko. And that will be our outstanding checks at the end of the month. Next naman, we have the bank error. So dito, tatandaan nyo ang rule natin. Kung sino nagkamali, siya ang mag-a-adjust. So kung si banko ang nagkamali, si banko ang mag-a-adjust sa balance niya. Kung si company ang nagkamali, that is called book errors. So dapat si books ang mag-a-adjust. So bank errors are items erroneously recorded by the bank. So, nagkamali si banko sa pag-record ng transactions in your bank account. So, example natin dito. A check payment of 100,000 has been recorded as 10,000. So, nag-encash, binayaran ni banko yung pinag-issuehan mo ng cheque ng 100,000, pero ang nadeduct lang ni banko ay 10,000. So, isipin natin. Ano nangyari? Nagkulang ba sa binawas? Or sumobra sa binawas. So, dito, a check payment of 100,000. Dapat 100,000 yung ibabawas sa banko sa balance mo. Pero 10,000 lang ang na-record niya. So, nagkulang siya ng binawas. Dahil nagkulang siya ng binawas, dapat magbabawas pa siya ulit. Pero magkano? 100,000 ba? O yung 10,000? Ang sagot ay kung magkano na lang yung kulang na binawas niya, which is 90,000. So, another example tayo. Kunwari, nag-deposit ka sa banko ng 10,000, pero ang na-record lang ni bank ay 1,000. Ulitin ko ang scenario. Nag-deposit ka ng 10,000, pero ang na-record lang ni banko na deposit mo ay 1,000. So, dito, nagkamali na naman si banko. So, dahil nagkamali si banko, titingnan natin. pag deposit kasi addition 'yan. So titingnan natin, sumobra ba ng dagdag or nagkulang sa dagdag. So 10,000 yung dineposit mo pero ang na-record lang ay 1,000. So sa scenario na 'yon, nagkulang ng dinagdag. Nagkulang si banko ng dinagdag sa balance mo. So dahil nagkulang ng dinagdag, dapat magdadagdag ka pa. So ang tanong, magkano ang idadagdag mo? Siyempre, yung difference lang, yung kulang sa pagdagdag. So 10,000 yon, pero 1,000 lang ang na-record, then dapat magdagdag ka pa ulit ng 9,000. So that is bank errors. So kung sino nagkamali, siyang mag-a-adjust. So kung si banko ang nagkamali, siya ang dapat mag-adjust. So for the book reconciling items naman, when we say book reconciling items, these are the items that are already reflected in your bank statement. Ibig sabihin, naka-record na siya sa books, sa banko, pero hindi pa siya naka-record sa books mo. Bakit hindi pa siya naka-record sa books mo? Kasi usually, ang bank statement nabibigay yan sa'yo a week after the end of the month. So halimbawa, yung bank statement mo for April. Yung bank statement mo for April, marereceive mo yan mga first week ng May. So ibig sabihin nun, kapag tinignan mo yung bank statement mo, hindi mo agad makikita dyan yung mga etong mga reconciling items na to, at hindi mo marerecord yan agad sa books mo kasi nga one week after the month pa mo marereceive yung bank statement. So book reconciling item, ulitin ko po, these are the items that are already recorded in the bank statement but not yet reflected or not yet recorded in your books. So we have bank credits, we have bank debits, and book errors. So bank credits, it will refer to the deposits made by the bank in the company's account but not yet reflected in the books of the company, of the company's records. So bank credit, these are any increases in your bank balance but it is not yet recorded in the books. So some example here are bank collections and process of bank loan, and also interest, the interest that you earn. So for example, si customer may utang sa iyo. Pero ang ginawa ni customer, instead na pumunta siya sa iyo para magbayad, ang ginawa niya, dineposit niya yung pera sa bank account mo. Pero itong customer na to, nakalimutan niyang i-inform ka na, uy, nagbayad na ako sa iyo through bank deposit. So, si ikaw, hindi mo alam na nag-deposit siya. Dahil hindi mo alam na nag-deposit siya, hindi mo pa yun marerecord sa books mo. Pero kay banko, dahil na-deposit na kay banko, nag-increase na yung balance mo sa banko. Pero ikaw, sa record mo, hindi pa. Hindi mo pa na-increase yung records mo sa cash dahil hindi ka pa informed na merong bayad si customer mo. So, those are bank credits na hindi pa reflected sa books mo. So, na-add na to kay banko, pero sa'yo, hindi pa. So, ang gagawin natin, dapat i-add natin sa records mo sa books. Next, we have bank debits. So, these are charges made by the bank against the company's account but not yet reflected in the company's record. So, any deductions in your bank balance, that is called bank debits. And these bank debits are not yet recorded in your company's record. Dahil nga, late mo na malalaman na merong mga ganito once na na-receive mo na yung bank statement. So, some example of these are charges for return checks due to NSF checks. Okay, pag sinabi natin NSF checks, ang ibig sabihin po niyan, non-sufficient funds checks. So, ibig sabihin, yung check-in na na-collecta natin, wala, either yung bank account ay kulang sa pondo, kaya hindi siya ma-encash yung banko. So, when we have NSF checks, service charges, any bank service charges such as checkbook printing, and that is being called bank debits. Also, hindi ko na-include yung book errors. So, book errors, katulad lang siya ni bank errors, pero this time, ang nagkamali ay si company sa pag-record. So, ito na po. How can we compute for the adjusted book balance? So, we will start with the unadjusted balance per book plus credit memo plus book errors less debit memo less book errors. So, kung mapapansin nyo, book errors is either add or minus. So, depende yan sa anong error ba yung na-commit mo. Then, after that, you will get the adjusted book balance. For the adjusted bank balance naman, it will start with the balance per bank plus deposit in transit plus bank errors less outstanding checks less bank errors. So, ang bank errors ulit, depende yan ha, is either add or minus. And you will get the adjusted bank balance. Plus, yung unadjusted balance per bank natin dito, yung nasa pinakataas, ayan yung ending balance natin sa bank statement. So, that is the balance of your cash in your bank statement at the end of the month. Okay, so, let's have some case. So, the October 31 bank statement of entity A shows a balance of 1,786,300. The balance of cash is 980,000. The following are the reconciling items. So, itong 1,786,300, that is your unadjusted bank balance. Next, the 980,000 here is the unadjusted book balance. Next, we have the bank returned a customer's check of 320,000 marked as NSF. So, NSF check, it is an example of bank debit. Next, the collection on October 31 amounting to 1,320,000 were placed in the bank overnight depository. This amount is not yet reflected in the October 31 bank statement. So, this is an example of deposit in transit. So, kung mapapansin nyo, ang una natin ginagawa dito ay we try to analyze kung ano bang type of reconciling item yung bawat transaction. Next is the bank charge entity A's account for 20,000 representing the cost of checkbooks requested from the bank. So, this is an example of bank debit. This is a service charge of the bank. Next is the bank collected a customer's note of 1,200,000. This collection is not yet recorded by entity A. So, this is an example of bank credit. Next, the bank credited entity A's account for interest net of tax amounting to 1,300. So, this is again an example of a bank credit. Next, the bank erroneously deducted a 135,000 check issued by another company from entity A's account. So, nagkamali si banko. Nag-deduction ng 135,000 pero hindi naman dapat i-deduct yon sa balance mo. So, this is an example of bank error na dapat natin i-add. Nagkamali ka ng bawas, so dapat ibalik mo yon, idagdag mo ulit. And also, outstanding checks amounted to 1,400,000. So, when we compute for this, for example, sa cash in bank, we will start with the unadjusted cash in bank, which is 1,786,300, we will add the deposit in transit of 1,320,000, add the book errors, di ba kanina, nagkamali si bank, so, plus, sorry, it should be bank errors at bank error, hindi yan book error. So bank error of 135,000. So nagkamali si banko. So dapat siya yung mag-a-adjust. So mag-a-adjust siya, i-add niya ulit yung 135,000 na naibawas niya. Less outstanding checks of 1,400,000 and we will get adjusted cash in bank. For the cash in book, we will start with the unadjusted cash in book, which is 980,000 plus collection by bank, 1,200,000 plus interest income, 1,300 less NSF checks amounting to 320,000 less bank charges of 20,000. So these are bank debits. And we will get the adjusted cash in books of 1,841,300. So dapat, in doing the bank reconciliation, our adjusted cash in bank will be equal to the adjusted cash in book, because this will be the one who will be reflected in our statement of financial position as your balance of cash. And that ends our discussion or review about bank reconciliation. So, last, for the midterm exam, hanggang dito po ang coverage po ng midterm exam natin. So, starting from the first lesson that we have discussed up to bank reconciliation. So, again, if you will have any question, don't hesitate to ask me. You can message me in the canvas, in Gmail, or in my messenger. So, salamat po, class.